Many people want to change the world, to change the way we live our life. But the sage of enlightened spirit say, no, change yourself. Because if we change ourselves, we change the world around us. Even if the world still stay the way it is, we are not affected. And if each person changes in this way, there's no need for any war, and there will be no disaster. If everyone has umbrella, raincoats, what is the need to change the season, to stop the rain, or to make the magical power to control the raining time, like many people would like to learn, and many people possess this magical power, can stop the rain, can make it lengthen, can push it to another direction. And it takes a long time to learn this magical skill. But why bother? Why bother? We just wear the raincoat. It's cheap, it's simple, and everyone can use it. Once the Buddha went to cross the river on boat, and the boatman did not want to take him because he had no money. At that time he was, of course, a renunciate, a monk still, who possessed no property. So the Buddha had no choice but to walk over the river. Yes. These days, quite a few yogis in India and Tibet and elsewhere still can do that. Many people ask me about the magical power because people are curious about things that they cannot explain, and also about things that they scientifically think is impossible. So I told them that yes, these things still exist, but nevertheless, it's not to be used at random, and also not to be done for show. Even Jesus, he possessed a lot of magical power, but he didn't always do it. He was very reluctant. Therefore, he raised only one dead person to life. He cured maybe only two or three blind persons, and not run around all the time and raise all the dead to life. That will bring the nature law into chaotic nature. And that is the thing an enlightened saint would not do. Each one has to learn to yearn within his heart to know himself, to know God. And then the kingdom of God will come. And the master will come to help that person. If we use magical power or any other supernatural way to convince people, we unknowingly lead people astray, because we limit God power within these magical skills, which could be learned by some expert. And also, by doing that, we interfere with the flow of nature, and of course we bring some disaster upon ourselves. Because what we seek is the eternal things, like wisdom, love, and the greatness of the universal power, not the small corner of these low level of games. But when we possess great wisdom, we also possess numerous miraculous power. But at that time, we have so much, too much, that we might not even know how much we have. And things just come out from us automatically without us intentionally doing anything. That's why the saints do things without doing, without even thinking, without even wanting to do it. It's just like a very, very rich person. He has no idea how much he has. He can never count, he can never see enough all of his treasure.